Hey everyone, it's HMK, and finally it's time for Super Mario Maker Review. Before I get into the review, I'd like to thank Nintendo of America for sending me Super Mario Maker to review and feature on my channel. You know, I have a good time with it, and you're gonna find out why in this review. Furthermore, be sure to follow me on Twitter and Facebook, because I'll be creating a video very, very soon featuring your levels, so you guys send me those codes. Make sure to build the most awesomest, hardest, freakiest, funnest levels that you can imagine. So, without further ado, let's get into the hectic review of Super Mario Maker. So, is Super Mario Maker worth all your time, money, effort, all that good jazz, and does it earn a place in your Wii U library? And I can say with a resounding yes, it does. Super Mario Maker is a blast to play, and this is not just coming from a Nintendo fan or anything, because at first, when I kept hearing things about Mario Maker and Super Mario Maker, I was like, another sandbox game, and Mario, Super Mario, you know, I'm always a huge fan of Super Mario, and making your own levels, they've got, you know, mods and things to do on the internet on your computer very, very easily. However, Super Mario Maker switches it up with a lot of cool things that you cannot find online. So this is a very good buy. Now, let's get into the reasons why I love Super Mario Maker, and I think you should get it as well. Super Mario Maker, at first I thought it was going to be overwhelming when it comes to creating levels or anything like that. However, this game is super accessible to anyone who picks up the game. It's not overwhelming at all. People, kids, adults, older adults, babies. But anyone, almost anyone can just jump right in and create levels. Because what Nintendo decided to do is when you first boot up the game, you only have a set amount of icons and things you can choose from when creating a level. And you can only choose from Super Mario Bros. Style at first. However, when you play 5 minutes with that certain style or, you know, whatever you have available at the time, it sets up a queue that you receive more things the very next day, which adds to what you already have. So you can have time to master what you already know in that realm. And the next day they add more stuff. And then you play 5 more minutes of that, you get more stuff the next day. So that way it doesn't really overwhelm you by unlocking everything at first. You get things in like sections. A lot of people complain about that. They want to, you know, have everything unlocked to make levels, make grand levels. But mostly those are for the hardcore gamers, and I understand their plight. However, when it comes to everyone, casual, hardcore, anyone in between, I feel this is a very, very good route that Nintendo decided to do, especially for people who thought they would be overwhelmed like myself with the amount of stuff that you can use to create levels. This is a very good tactic. Now, aside from how you get the things to create levels, creating levels is extremely easy and very straightforward. You know, I was also afraid about that, about overwhelming things to create with, and is creation itself gonna be like too hard? No, it's not. I can tell you right away, it's one of the easiest things to do. Nintendo sets up a great interface with the Wii U gamepad, and you know, you just go in there and create. Just have a blast. Just whatever comes to your mind, just go. Just fucking do it. You don't understand, guys. It's like, with the interface of the Wii U gamepad has going on with the stylus, it's very, very easy to drag and drop, create, draw, not even draw, but like, you know, draw with bricks, draw with hidden blocks, all that stuff. I say the interface is very casual friendly, and in turn, that makes the hardcore gamers work and create even faster, so that's great. Over time, you're gonna unlock everything. I think it's a maximum of 9 days, I would say 10 days, I'm not really sure, but like over the course of about a week and change is when you unlock everything, unless you wanna cheat and, you know, set up your timer in order to unlock everything at first, but whatever. If you wanna go the regular route, which I recommend, it'll take about like a week and change in order to unlock everything. And when you do unlock everything, you have a bunch of stuff to choose from, ranging from 4 gameplay styles of Mario games. 4 distinct Mario styles to choose from, which range from Super Mario Brothers, Super Mario Bros. 3, Super Mario World, and New Super Mario Bros. U. Every Mario style has gameplay that stays true to the original game. So if you're building a level from Super Mario World and decide to switch it to Super Mario Bros. 3 on the fly, you have to take that into account, that you won't have certain abilities or items that pertain to each game, especially for New Super Mario Bros. U, including wall jumping and spin jumps and all that stuff. Even though Super Mario World has no spin jumps, but no wall jumping. And I gotta say, I had a blast creating levels, you know, finding new ways to tinker and taking notes from other creations that I've seen online and implementing them into my stage to make hellish courses that no one can beat. Of all my courses, they have less than 5% win rate. I have a course that I'll leave in the comment section below if you guys want to try, and that's under 1% win rate. Let's see if you can beat that. But Super Mario Maker isn't just about creating levels, it's about playing them, and that's where you get the massive replay value. You can play stages from anyone across the globe if they have the game and internet, of course. Some of these levels are very, very easy and just fun, mostly eye candy, and some of these levels are blisteringly hard. You don't understand. And the creativity that flows into these levels is immense. It's staggering how many people can create all these different courses, each bursting with creativity, more creative than the last. It's really, really crazy. There are some courses where you just have to stay still and wait just for a mushroom to fall at the very last second so you don't get killed by a bomb when the flag is right in your fucking face but you can't reach it. You have to wait for a bomb to explode the bricks around you. It's crazy. And that's one thing with Super Mario Maker when you're playing online. Because of all this random stuff and all these people want to do hidden blocks, there's an underlying sense of panic and mistrust when playing levels online because of all the bullshit that people can add to games, such as hidden blocks and death rooms and all that other stuff. It keeps you on your toes, but that's part of the fun. Seriously, as long as this community lasts, and what I've seen with Super Mario itself as an icon and Super Mario Maker with all these levels being created, you will have an endless amount of levels from 4 gameplay styles to play from. So literally, this is a game that never ends. Also, as a quick side note, this game is a great way to make use of a bunch of amiibos if you are amiibo hunting or you have a bunch of amiibos just standing there. This game is compatible with nearly every amiibo that will be in existence. And that is just crazy. I have a bunch of amiibos and I borrow amiibos from friends in order to unlock the costumes that can only be played in the Super Mario Brothers style. But those are really fun. Those are very, very interesting. They're just, it's good fun. One complaint that I do have is that it's very tedious in order to find levels. You're going to have to put in this code, kind of like how the old Wii friend code system worked. And you can't even find levels that you want through name, because I understand why, because I mean, if people name their courses the same, and it's bound to happen, but you can't really find them on the listing through the course bot menu or the course world menu or whatever. Other than that small gripe, I think that Super Mario Maker is a hellish good time. And if you have a Wii U, this is a game that needs to be in your library. And if you don't have a Wii U, I say that there's a good reason to get one. Honestly, the amount of content, the amount of tools to create, the amount of levels that you get back from people from this awesome community is way too big to pass up. And you know, this game is actually selling pretty damn well, and Nintendo knows why. So with full confidence, I say that you should go out and buy Super Mario Maker. If I were to give this thing a score, I'd give it 9 out of 10. 10 out of 10? Nah, 9 out of 10. Because I mean, it's Super Mario Maker. It's really, like, the core of the game, how good it is and how long it will last, really depends on the community that backs it. So if at any point where Super Mario Maker just goes down the drain, other than that, it's a great game to play. It's a great game to use to create. So go get Super Mario Maker. Man, just, and this game is just so good. And I can't wait to play a bunch of courses that you guys created. I've done so already, and they're awesome. So, until the next Super Mario Maker video, I've been HMK! Get creating, get Super Mario making, and I'll check you guys later.